Okay, welcome back. This is part two. So this one is about people that are just needy and why you keep attracting those people. In my opinion, there's four solid reasons why you're attracting clingy people. You either A, have a very strong, vibrant personality. You're very attractive to people. You walk in a room, people notice you. People can see the confidence it exudes out of you. There's a certain aura that people who have confidence within themselves, people can read that without you even opening up your mouth. It's the way you walk, the way you carry yourself. That's an aura, that's a vibe. We are all vibrational beings. Even this inanimate object is vibrating right now. Everything is vibrating. That's where vibes comes from. Y'all be talking about, you know the vibes, but do you know the vibes? Your magnetic, strong personality is pulling people in. A lot of the times it pulls in people who lack that within themselves. They cling to that because it's like, wow, this is somebody that's confident, that has their own mind, and that's how I want to be. The second reason that you could be attracting clingy people is you're very kind-hearted, very empathetic, compassionate, you know what I'm saying? You're a good listener. They feel safe. They feel like they can open up to you. They feel very vulnerable and free to be themselves. You don't judge people. You're nurturing, you're giving. Empaths, for example, are going to attract a lot of clingy people because they feel people's emotions and people feed on that. You start reading them and now for the first time they feel seen. They feel heard. Wow, this person gets me. When you're a very compassionate person, you're gonna attract the people who are wounded and who are hurt. They're gonna cling to this sweetness that you give off that makes them feel safe and make them feel better about themselves. Another reason why you're gonna attract clingy friends is they have a benefit that they gain by being your friend. A clouded person, or you're very well connected, VIP this, you know the NFL players, whatever the case may be. You're gonna definitely attract clingy friends because they wanna get in where they fit in. They wanna be on the mixtape six. They wanna be in with the cool kids. They wanna be around you because of what you can do for them. Those are clout chasers. They're around because they wanna look better or they wanna get to a certain level. Posting them, taking pictures with them, showing everybody, look who I'm with. Those types of people, those weirdos, beware of those people. Cut them people out immediately because they are not your real friends. I promise you they're not. They want to use you for your connections, your perks. And then the last one, it kind of goes back to the empathetic thing, but you're just a real genuine person and you keep it real with people. You're not judgmental. You're just your authentic self all of the time. That's a very attractive quality to people because a lot of people put on a show for people. For people that don't know how to be themselves, when they get around somebody that's authentically themselves, no matter how goofy, lame, nerdy, geeky, that is a strength. That's how everybody wants to be, but they want to be themselves, but they don't have the courage or the strength to be themselves. So when you have these situations, it's important that you set boundaries because they may not be jealous and negative, but they're requiring too much of your energy. They drain you of your light source, quite literally feeding off your life source. You have this light that exudes out of you that's so bright, so they're attracted to it like a moth to a flame. Eventually, they're going to start to dim your light because they're clinging onto your energy. It's important that you set these boundaries with people when they're taking too much of your energy and too much of your time to protect yourself and protect your energy. So some examples of setting boundaries would be not answering the phone every time somebody calls. You don't have to give nobody no explanation. It's your life. If they get mad, let them go. They have to learn that they can't be entitled to your time and your space. Don't just ghost somebody and just fall off the face of the earth. That's rude. But I'm just saying, you don't want to answer the phone. You don't have to text them like, sorry, I'm doing this. Like, if you don't answer the phone, you don't answer the phone. Call them back when you can, even if that's tomorrow or next week. Why are you getting mad? You didn't call me back yesterday. Like, my bad. I got a life. You should have a life. And maybe that sounds harsh, but you don't always gotta text back. You don't gotta text back right away. You don't always gotta invite them to everything you're doing. You don't owe nobody nothing. Simply saying no. It's okay to say no. And that's what I struggle with. I sometimes would not set boundaries because I didn't want to have to explain why I didn't want to do something. Or I didn't want to have to explain why I'm saying no, because the real reason may be because I just don't feel like it. Or just because I want to be alone. I just be feeling bad sometimes when I know people want to hang out, or I know people want to do this, or they want me to come here. I'm the life of the party. It is what it is. I'm not trying to be on no cocky stuff. I'm gonna bring that energy up. That's who I know who I am. So when I say I'm not coming, it's always a, bye. I got certain friends that will literally say, if you're not coming, I'm not going. And I hate that. It's something I'm currently learning how to do as well, setting boundaries. And me doing that more often has created so much more peace in my life. Now I know I don't have to always please everybody, because you're not gonna always please people. Somebody gonna be disappointed. Somebody feelings gonna be hurt. It is what it is. Let it ride. Just be empathetic of the fact that a lot of times clingy people just don't have a lot of friends. You know what I'm saying? They don't have a lot of people who are like you in their life. So they cling to that because it's special to them. There's a lot of people out here that don't have real friends or don't know know what real friendship is like. Everybody may not have what you have. So when you have clingy people, be empathetic, set boundaries. Just because somebody clingy doesn't mean that they a bad person. It just means that they really enjoy your company. They really enjoy being around you. If they not, you know, no hater or no jealous person, it's not like you gotta cut them off. You just gotta keep them at arm's length. All right, I hope you enjoyed the second part of this spiritual warfare installment. The third part is the importance of keeping your circle small.